Hello. Well, if you feel like what I'm about to say you heard it a couple of days ago, well, you will be right. Your mind is not playing tricks on you. The initial video that I published, I used the wrong product in the presentation and I felt I needed to fix that. You see, as a medical doctor, I owe you a duty of care. And I feel that if I'm recommending or suggesting any intervention, especially if it is based on research, then it's got to be on point. And if it isn't, then I've got to fix that. So where was I? Well, I was talking about the fact that I actually love fruits and vegetables and that you too should actually love your fruits and vegetables. So if I love my fruits and vegetables, what's the problem? Well, the problem is pesticide contamination of our fruits and vegetables. I sympathize with farmers. They have to use pesticides to actually increase their yield at the end of the season. But that is not to say pesticides are good for human consumption. Pesticides have actually been linked to a host of medical conditions, things like neurodegenerative diseases, birth defects, respiratory problems, as well as cancers. Hence my concern. Now, one solution is for you to buy organic produce, but even that is not foolproof because organic farmers actually do use pesticides. It's just that they use a lot less than other farmers. So what should you do? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you four methods that you can actually use to reduce your exposure to the pesticides in our fruits and vegetables. The first method is the bare minimum you should do. The other three, well, you should adopt them and you should use them every now and again. So what am I talking about? Well, you stay tuned and I'll see you in a couple of seconds.
Now for today's 2020 idea to better health, please welcome on stage Dr. Joe.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. Joe of the drjoe.com. Now, if this is your first time on this channel, can I extend a warm welcome to you? This is your home of 2020 ideas for better health. So if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. And also, please do not forget to click on the notification bell because that's how you get notified of future videos that I make. So today's video is about how we can actually reduce our exposure to pesticides in our fruits and vegetables. So I'm just going to give you four methods that you can use to reduce your exposure. Well, you know, you might be asking, well, actually the fruits and vegetables I get from my supermarket, they look clean, so why should I bother trying to clean them again? Well, the point is, for a start, you cannot actually see the pesticides on the fruits and vegetables. And secondly, your supermarket wash is only concerned with removing dirt from the produce. So they're not interested at all in getting rid of pesticides. So it's your responsibility as an adult to actually get rid of the pesticide residue in the fruits and vegetables that you buy. So I'm going to use strawberries for this demonstration. Why strawberries? Well, A, I like strawberries, one of my favorite fruits. B, strawberries have actually been classified as the dirtiest fruit in the fruits and veg category when fruits and vegetables have been tested. So it's probably not a bad idea to use strawberries as an example. So method number one is very simple. Method number one, this is the bare minimum that you should do. All you need to do is put your strawberries in a strainer. Very important, you should use a strainer. And then you simply run water over the strawberries, and at the same time you are washing the strawberries, just moving them around. Okay, you do that, and what you're trying to do here, you're trying to leach off the pesticides off the produce. That's all you need to do. So let it run, and you do this for about a minute, and when you do that, it will get rid of, you know, most of the pesticides, not all of it, but most of it. Okay, so that's the first method, method number one. Method number two requires the use of alkaline electrolyzed water. You may be asking yourself, what is alkaline electrolyzed water? Well, essentially, you're going to need a water ionizer to actually get your alkaline electrolyzed water. Now, if you've got a water ionizer in your house already, great. If you're looking to get one at the end of this video, I'm going to leave links down below if you want to get one for yourself. They don't come cheap though, so just something for you to be aware of. But what is clear is that it's been shown by research that the alkaline electrolyzed water is actually very effective in cleaning our produce, in getting rid of pesticides. The alkaline electrolyzed water is actually a disinfectant as well as a cleanser. So you end up having two functions from one product. So how do you make your alkaline electrolyzed water? You add salt into the water in the water ionizer, and of course you run the current through the water ionizer, and you end up with two products, an acidic water in one chamber and alkaline water in the other chamber. What you need for cleaning purposes is the alkaline water. That alkaline water is what's actually called alkaline electrolyzed water, AEW. And that water contains sodium hydroxide, and that is what's going to do the cleaning for you. So all you need to do is add your strawberries or any produce that you have into the alkaline water. Let the produce soak there for about 10 to 15 minutes and you're good to go. You're going to end up with very clean products as shown in this research and this other research. That's method number two. Method number three is, before I talk about method number three, note to self, use the right product. Because this was where I used the wrong product the last time in the demonstration. So what you need is baking soda. That's what you need for method number three. Now, in the initial video, I used baking powder. I mean, it's okay, it's just that baking powder has less sodium bicarbonate compared to baking soda. Baking soda is purely sodium bicarbonate. So that's what you need. And it's based on this research that was done a couple of years ago that showed that baking soda is very effective in cleaning produce. So here's a demonstration for you. You need step one for method number three. You need to add some water into a bowl and then you open up your baking soda. Add about 2 good tablespoonful of the baking soda into the water. That's one there. And that's two. So baking soda. And then give it some time to dissolve. Let it dissolve. It's almost like salt, really. It's just like a table salt. Let it dissolve. And what you do next, you just add the produce into the baking soda water. Just like I'm doing here. So you add the produce, in this case I've got the strawberries in there, and let it soak for a good 15 minutes and then come back 15 minutes later, and then we're going to revert back to what we did in method number one. Pour the produce with the soda water there, and then you have to rinse using a strainer as well, okay? Rinse that way and just move the produce around the strainer just to wash off everything. So you're also leaching the pesticides off the produce when you do this. Okay, so that's method number three. So method number four. Method number four requires using a vinegar solution because you've got acetic acid here. It's the acetic acid that is going to do the cleaning. Any vinegar solution will do. I've got apple cider vinegar here, the Bragg's brand. You can use any vinegar. It doesn't have to be apple cider vinegar. You can use red wine vinegar, white vinegar, rice vinegar. It doesn't matter. Any vinegar. So all you need to do is just similar to method number three. You're going to add about one part of the vinegar to 4 parts of water. Okay. So here I'm just going to add that's 1 tablespoonful, 2, 3, 4. So you just have to estimate, usually about 4 parts of water to 1 part of the vinegar solution. So is the acetic acid, just mix it up, make sure it's thoroughly mixed. And then you add the produce just like we did for method number three. You just add the produce again. And with the vinegar method, you have to let it soak a little bit longer, a minimum of 20 minutes, preferably 30 minutes. Okay, let it soak for a good 30 minutes, and then you come back after 30 minutes, and then you do as we did in step one. Pour the produce and the vinegar solution with the produce into a strainer, and then you rinse again, just like we did. Every time you do this, you're leaching the pesticides off the produce, okay? And you just wash them again. You do that. So once you do this, you know that your produce is now safe to be eaten. There you go. Four methods there for you to adopt to reduce your exposure to the pesticides in our fruits and vegetables. Now, if you got some value from this video, as usual, give it a thumbs up. If you are using any other method that is actually working for you to reduce your exposure, please let us know about it down below. And if you got any other comments to make regarding this video, please leave your comments down below as well. Please share this video with your friends, your family, and your colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. And I think that's about it. Until next time, well, this is Dr. Joe signing out.